Hello children, welcome to our buddy class. We are learning chapter 2 inverse trigonometry functions, and in that we are doing miscellaneous exercises, and we are now in question number 13. We'll solve it now. So question number 13 is 2 into tan inverse of cos x is equal to tan inverse of 2 cosecant x. So this left hand side alone we can compare it with the formula, that is 2 tan inverse of x is equal to tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. See, in this property or in this formula, in place of x we have cos x. So right hand side of this formula also we can substitute there. So my left hand side will be tan inverse of 2 into cos x divided by 1 minus x square is cos square x, which is equal to tan inverse of 2. See, this cosecant x I can write as 1 by sin x. Okay. Now see, both the sides we have tan inverse and tan inverse. So we can equate the functions alone. We are not supposed to cancel. By comparing, we are just equating the function. That is 2 cos x divided by 1 minus cos square x equal to 2 divided by sin x. See, both the sides we have 2. So I can cancel it, and cos x divided by 1 minus cos square x can be written as sin square x is equal to 1 by sin x. So I can cancel one of this sin x with this sin x. So I will be remaining with cos x by sin x, which is equal to 1. So which implies cos x by sin x is cot x equal to 1. So what will be my x here? So x value is 1, which is pi by 4. Okay, from the table value, from the trigonometric value of thetas, so cot inverse of 1 is pi by 4. Therefore our x value is pi by 4. Okay, that's all the sum, children. Now we'll move on to the next problem. So next question is question number 14. Look at it. Tan inverse of 1 minus x divided by 1 plus x equal to 1 by 2 tan inverse of x, where x is greater than 0, and we are going to solve it. Solve it means we are going to find the value of x. Okay. See, for doing this, see, my left hand side I have tan inverse. So if I make this function in terms of tan function again, I can simply equate it, right? I can simplify it further. So what I am doing, instead of x I am just writing, put x equal to tan theta. Okay, so my left hand side will be tan inverse of 1 minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan theta. Okay. Now the right hand side will be 1 by 2 tan inverse of, and we have assumed x as tan theta, right? So in place of x substitute tan theta. Okay. Now see, I can relate it with the formula or with the property tan A minus tan B, right? But I want tan function here. This also we have seen many times in solving the previous sums that 1 can be written as tan pi by 4. So remaining is tan theta divided by 1 plus, and in this tan theta I can write as one into tan theta. Okay, so instead of this one only, I'm gonna write here tan pi by 4 into tan theta. Okay, which is equal to tan inverse, will get neutral, so 1 by 2 into theta. Okay, so next step, see tan inverse of, so what is the property here, we can write it as tan pi by 4 minus theta, which is equal to theta by 2. Okay, again tan and tan inverse get neutral, so pi by 4 minus theta is equal to theta by 2. So let me take this theta to the other side, so pi by 4 equal to theta by 2 plus theta, therefore pi by 4 equal to 3 theta by 2. Okay, so now I can cancel this, right, 2 1 times 2, 2 times 4. Okay, so next we'll have, if I bring this 3 to the other side, it will come to the denominator, so which implies theta equal to pi by 6, and our aim is to find the x value, right, and we already assume that x equal to tan theta. Okay, so theta value is pi by 6, right, tan pi by 6, tan pi by 6 is 1 by root 3. Okay, so x value is 1 by root 3. So that's all the solution. So what we have done here, just to make the function as tan function, I have substituted x equal to tan theta. Okay, so using the properties, we got the value of theta as pi by 6. So tan pi by 6 is 1 by root 3. That's all the problem. We'll move on to the next question. So the 15th question is sine of tan inverse of x, where mod x is less than 1 is equal to. So this value is equal to what? Among these 4 options, which is the correct options we have to find. Okay, see, for solving this, let me assume that theta equal to tan inverse of x. So tan theta is equal to x, right. So what will be sine theta for this value? So for finding this, see, tan theta is x means x by 1. So that this will be the opposite side and this will be the adjacent side, right. Tan is sine by cos, and this will be the opposite and denominator will be the adjacent side. So while applying it on a right angle triangle, when you apply it on a right angle triangle, we'll find it the sine value. Okay, so the opposite side, let it be theta and this be 90 degree, and opposite side is x, adjacent side is 1. So your hypotenuse will be x square plus 1, right. So what will be the sine theta now? Sine theta will be x by square root of x square plus 1. Okay, what is theta? We assumed tan inverse of x, right. So sine of tan inverse of x is equal to x divided by square root of x square plus 1. Okay, so which is the correct option? You see, x square plus 1 can be written as 1 plus x square also. So your correct option is D. In your book, the correct option is D. So in C option, you will get 1 by square root of 1 plus x square only in your book. Okay, so the correct option is option D. Okay, so that's all the problem. We'll move on to the next problem. So next question is again an objective question, C16th question. Sin inverse of 1 minus x minus 2 sin inverse of x equal to pi by 2, then what is the x value? This question we can easily find out by using the objectives itself, options itself. Okay, if you substitute 0, 1 by 2 and other options also, you can find the correct answer. But if this question is asked in some other category other than MCQs, what you will do? So we'll give you the direct answer now. So for solving this, that is for solving for x, we'll substitute sin inverse of x equal to theta. That is, let us assume sin inverse of x equal to theta. Therefore, x equal to sin theta. So now my left hand side, okay, let us consider the left hand side. See, sin inverse of 1 minus x minus 2 into sin inverse of x only I have considered as theta equal to pi by 2. Now let me take this 2 theta to the other side. So sin inverse of 1 minus x equal to pi by 2 plus 2 theta. Okay. Now let me take this sin inverse to the other side. So I will get 1 minus x is equal to sin of pi by 2 plus 2 theta. Okay. So what is pi by 2? 90 degree, right? So 90 degree plus theta, what will happen to the sine? It will change its value. So 1 minus x equal to sine will change as cos theta. So cos 2 theta, right? So now what happened? We need to find x, right? So what we'll do? Let me take this x to the other side. Let me take this cos to this other side. So x equal to, we'll have 1 minus cos 2 theta, which is 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square theta. Okay, so 2 into sin square theta is what? Sin theta is x, sin square theta is x square. So x equal to 2x square. Okay, so let me take it to the other side. X minus 2x square equal to 0. So let me take x common. So 1 minus 2x equal to 0. By comparing with 0 or equating with 0, I will get x equal to 0 or x equal to 1 by 2. Now in this function, if I substitute 1 by 2, I will not get pi by 2. So if x equal to 1 by 2, then the equation is not true. 1 by 2 is not satisfying this equation. So x value is 0 here. So the right option is option C. Okay. So that's all, children, the question number 16. So I hope you understand. So we'll move on to the next question. So the next question is question number 17. See, they have given some function, that is tan inverse of x by y minus tan inverse of x minus y by x plus y is equal to this function. We have to find the value and equal to what we have to find. Okay. See, just by taking at a glance, don't you remember this property, tan A minus tan B? and we have seen this n number of times in this chapter. So I hope you already know that tan inverse of a minus b divided by 1 plus ab, right? So we'll do it now. Okay, so here in place of a I have x by y, in place of b I have x minus y by x plus y. So the right hand side will be tan inverse of x by y minus x minus y by x plus y. X plus y, the whole divided by 1 plus, since it is minus here, here we will have plus 1 plus x by y into x minus y divided by x plus y. And again, simplification of problems like this also we have seen many times in this chapter. So let me go on directly to the simplified answer. Tan inverse of, I'll have x plus x square plus y square divided by x square plus y square on simplifying this. Okay, this normal your algebraic simplification only, so nothing difficult in this. So I'm directly going to the answer. Okay, so tan inverse of 1, both numerator denominator are same, so that I can cancel and it is 1. When will my tan inverse be 1? When theta is what? When theta is pi by 4, right? When theta is pi by 4 only, it is 1. Okay. So, our option is, correct option is option C, pi by 4. That's all. That's all the answer. So, with this, our chapter is over. Okay, so in this chapter, what is important thing you have to learn is, first is principal branch value of each and every trigonometry function, their domain and range, and you have to get thorough with the properties of trigonometric function and also the inverse trigonometric functions, and some formulas you have to be memorized, and that's all in this chapter. And this carries very less weightage in your public exam, but then such an easy chapter, I don't want you to get less marks. So you get thorough with all these properties and formulas so that you'll get full marks in this chapter. So next class, we'll see you with another new chapter. Thank you.
For more queries, please contact Buddy on 9840844987 or visit buddy.life.